students of Colorado College. I'm Toni Jensen, and I was the judge this year for the Adelaide Bender Reville Prize for Nonfiction. So I'm just making a little video to talk about the winners of the contest and their work. First, I'd like to say congratulations to all of you. You're really good writers. I was very surprised this was an undergraduate competition. You're all really turning in excellent grad level, publishable level sorts of work. So I'll go ahead and get started. And hello from Arkansas, by the way. That's where I'm sending this little video from. Okay, so in third place for the Adelaide Bender Reville Prize for Nonfiction is Lara Smith's Großeltern, which is, I'm sure, not quite how you pronounce that because it's in German. I understand it means grandparents. This short essay portrays an honest, well-detailed coming-of-age story. The story unfolds in scenic, precise moments, from the chlorine of the swimming pool to the shattering of pottery on the grandparents' stairs. Readers will not soon forget all the essay reveals about the dysfunction in this house and how it plays out generation to generation. Each scene takes real risk that pays off in the end, with the narrator understanding all the women in the family better, even herself. Number two for the second place prize is Callie Zucker's essay 72, which startles with its inventive language and direct approach to difficult subject matter. The narrator undergoes a series of medical and mental health moments that are harrowing, heartbreaking, and beautifully rendered. The mix of narrative moment with a strong, surprising voice draws the reader through each section like a sharp spin on a fast merry-go-round. And then for the first place, Rachel Frizell's essay, Probe, which delves into the deep territory of how women's bodies are treated and mistreated within families, in public spaces, and especially in the medical community. Each scene holds a key moment of unraveling, and each moment is delivered through the most precise and evocative language. By this essay's end, the narrator has no more answers about her body than when the essay began. But readers both know and feel so much more about her life and about women's lives through the essay's careful attention to its subject. You may see coming into frame here a paw. This is Bella the dog. Say hi, Bella. Bella, you want to say hi? Oh, Bella's not saying hi. Well, here's Bella. And there goes Bella. All right. So that's the unprofessional ending with a paw and part of a big, big dog in frame. But I hope all of you are having a good celebration, and that even though you can't be together, that you're celebrating these incredible achievements in nonfiction and all the other categories. I wish you the best from Arkansas. Take care.